This feels like a perfect robotic vacuum at the moment, and finally maybe a true challenger to the so popular Roborock series. For less than $350, maps, smart home integration and reasonable suction power, is it really that good? That's right, testing is the only way to find out. Welcome everyone, it's Michael speaking, and Tech4O is the place where we inspect cool tech and help you to make the right buying decisions. In the first half of 2020, there already are a handful of awesome choices for vacuum cleaners, and there clearly are some that stand out in terms of good features and pricing. While performance is already comparable, it's the smart features and customer care that usually drive your choice towards a certain model. And so far, the Sigma Spark ticks all the boxes, about which I'm gonna tell you in a while. We are now examining the pricing and the background of this company. Turns out that Sigma are providing most of the internals for similar products of way larger brands like Kehe, Haier, Procynic and so on. A big enough proof that this is not another random garage maker. Two devices with the brand Sigma are available at the moment, Spark and Seeker. With the Spark, also known as the 980, it's the more premium and featuring laser radar, the best-in-class navigation, as well as a lot of smartness, language packs and map functions, and it easily challenges the market leaders at much more attractive price. Right now it costs slightly above $300 for the regular version, and you can upgrade it with a water tank or buy the combo for about $40 more. And even though it costs about half of the current most popular Roborock and one-third of the similar featured iRobot Roomba devices, it doesn't feel like being any worse than this, meaning that we have to look into the details and figure out how all that converts into real-life experience. Nothing unusual about the unboxing, and this is how the non-wet mopping version is packed. But I also got the water tank, so we're going to test the wet mopping capabilities as well. The main unit is 7.5 cm high, 2 cm less than the Roborock S5, and this is a key and very significant difference, because finally a robot is now well suitable to pass under most of my kitchen cupboards. Having plastic design, it looks well built, the black color is fine, 2 buttons for operation and obviously a lot of sensors. The wheelbase looks to be flexible and allowing climbing onto high surfaces, more importantly, carpets. Before powering on, let's talk about some of the specs and see the placement of the bins. 1600 Pascal suction power, not the strongest in its class, but way above the average, and with optimized airflow, which makes a big difference. 3600 mAh battery, this is enough for 100 minutes of continuous sucking or mopping, which is a good value and good enough for areas up to 100, maybe 150 square meter. Climbing is up to 15 mm and I noticed that it easily passes the high carpets from IKEA, which is still a challenge for some robots. Oh, and speaking of carpets, there's a sensor detecting them and the robot enters into a boost mode. Not as effective as some other vacuums though. But if you need extra suction power, there's a slider in the app that does that. Equipped with 3 brushes, 2 on the front and a main V-shaped brush to collect all the pet hair and small objects from the ground, of course with quick release mechanism for easy cleaning. And the dustbin? 600 milliliters. Sounds about right. That's actually a lot, especially compared to the average. As a reference, 480 milliliters for the Roborock S6. However, the Roomba 960 has the same 600 milliliter capacity. It stores a lot of dust and my recommendation is to empty it on a regular basis because this guarantees optimal airflow and more efficient suction. More interestingly, there's a motor inside that dustbin and it appears to get power via these connectors on the side. This is a pretty interesting decision and turns out to be quite effective. Quick look at the water tank too. As stated, it's an optional accessory and is electronically controlled and also has the capacity of 600 milliliters, and being a separate to the dust box means that the Sigma Spark cannot suck and mop at the same time, but its good battery life allows doing both on a single battery charge, even for large rooms and houses. When testing vacuums, I usually show you the navigation algorithm, test the efficiency by spreading some rice because it simulates collecting larger debris, where some devices may perform actually worse, like the Viomi V2 Pro by Xiaomi, which turned out to disappoint with the rice test, but then managed to compensate this with awesome mopping efficiency. And we are, of course, looking at the overall performance and the smart functions. So yeah, besides the regular testing, a smartphone app walkthrough would be involved too. I need to say that the Zigma Spark has now been my primary robot at home for a while, and my impressions are very positive. The dry cleaning is absolutely fantastic, and I'm impressed with the way the robot handles edges and figures out about different obstacles. The movements are very precise, doesn't seem to leave unclean spots, and very importantly, the scope of these front brushes seems to be very effective, especially for areas where access is limited. Carpets are being easily cleaned too. Overall, doesn't seem to fall behind any of its famous bigger brothers, and the amount of dust collected well corresponds to what I usually collect on a weekly basis, which confirms the good effectiveness. To the debris cleaning test, because of the laser navigation and the maps created, this robot is not doing any unnecessary or chaotic movements and managed to return some of the spilled rice within a few minutes. However, a little disappointing result. Looks like having two front brushes could actually cause the rice pieces to get out of reach of the robot. Putting the rice aside, the Zigma will collect powder, flour, even cereal in a much better way. The wet cleaning is also superb. I'd say goes beyond the expectations. Only inconvenience is the fact it is a separate box and it cannot perform suction and mopping simultaneously, but we know that often hybrid solutions could be having corners cut. Only remark to Zigma, I wish that an anti-moisture pad was included in the package so that we guarantee that wooden surfaces won't suffer in the case of robot getting stuck somewhere and water spilling. I have to say some good words about the app and the smart home integration functions. Initially, I was quite reserved, but that easily changed. Very simple to connect to the home network. Just open the app, follow the instructions. Within less than a minute, you will be scrolling to the vacuum configuration as I am. There aren't any reminders about cleaning the sensors or showing you the technical parameters in depth, but you have amazingly well-served data. As for the cleaning duration, for example, a room with such a map with floor surface of around 10 square meters gets cleaned for around 11 minutes. 9 square meters area with no carpets and obstacles for about 6 minutes. Looks like approximately it needs around a minute for more complex areas and around half of a minute for larger places with less furniture inside. You will be able to see the progress in real time, and also the data is backed up to the clouds from an app which seems to respect GDPR, and it's in fact very responsive and surprisingly bugless. Virtual walls are defined by you, and you simply draw this on the map and you can restrict some zones. And there are some further updates expected, like saving multi-floor maps, which could be a flagship killer feature. While the advertisement stated that there's a carpet auto mode, I couldn't find such trigger in the menus. However, I found a turbo mode, which suddenly increases the power, and that can easily be noticed, but very much affects the battery life because it consumes around 1.5% per minute. The standard mode is more balanced and noise is below 60 dB with possibility to operate for up to 2 hours. Oh, and very easy to integrate with smart home management. Adding to Alexa took me like a minute. And the skill can start and stop the cleaning, and you of course can count on scheduling either via your preferred AI assistant or the app or the remote control. So the robot is really well equipped. I truly think it deserves greater popularity and comes very close to what the good old Roborock S5 offers, except the battery life. In fact, the only disadvantage I can feel so far is only that, because the rest totally fine, and thanks to the more compact form factor and longer side brushes, it tends to do better job than the Roborock in some areas. I think for a little more than 300 bucks, it is an outstanding choice. And I can say for sure that in 2020, even mid-range vacuums offer fantastic functionality and can often be a great home helper at an awesome price. For now, I think I'm gonna keep the Sparky around for a while, and in case you wonder whether I've switched to something else or found a reason to get disappointed, just ask in the comments below. This is all about this episode, and I'd love to hear about your opinion. More info and links to the devices shown you gotta find in the description below the video. It's been awesome to give me the chance to present you the Zigma Spark. With wishes for a wonderful day, gonna have the wishes to take a good care of yourself and your home, and see you soon enough in the next episode. Cheers!